The Nigerian government has approved the sum of 9.2 billion naira for the purchase of cooking stoves and what it calls wonder bags for the distribution to rural women under the National Clean Cooking Scheme. The government says the move is an aggressive drive to engender clean cooking culture among the poor rural women to reduce and possibly eliminate cooking with solid fossil, which is detrimental to health. The government says it would buy 750,000 units of the cooking stoves and 18,000 wonder bags and distribute to the rural women free of charge. The stoves are to be expected to be delivered within the next 12 weeks. But speaking on our flagship news and current affairs program, Deji 360, political analyst Ni Akinshiju argued that the government was getting its priorities wrong.
The stove is not a problem at this time. We've been talking about agriculture. When you acquire a stove, what would you cook with the stove? Where would you get those things that you cook with? The problem with rural Nigeria is not what how they will cook, because I know the average rural home in Nigeria use kerosene fired stove at this time. But the problem is getting what to cook on that stove. And so when we talk of hunger, it's about access to agricultural products, you know, because food in whatever variety is in scarce supply for the average rural person, and including the urban people anyway, you know. And the truth of the matter is, when the national government decide at a point in time like this, where you just declare the austerity measure, the prices of crude oil has continuously fallen. I mean, it's falling continuously. And you now say, okay, you have little receipts.
You've devalued your naira.
And you devalue your naira, you increase interest rates, and so there are so many confusion in the system, and it does not as if you could not foresee the confusion coming, the problems coming, because you could see over the last 1 year that your major buyers, the major buyers of your crude oil was retreating, had actually found its own source of supply, you know, and you had to go more or less to other segments of the market to get buyers. And you could also obviously see your receipts falling over time. If you have good policy makers, they could actually project into the next 1-2 years and determine these are the kind of problems we are going to have. Now, if we have such policymakers thinking that these are the kind of problems we are going to have, we're going to land ourselves in austerity measure, which means that we have to cut back on our consumptions and all that. Who are those people in the policymaking body that will now say in the next 1 year, what we need most is stove?
And 9.2 billion, just help us make some economic sense of this. It's a huge amount of money.
I cannot make.
And should it be the responsibility of the national government to provide stoves for rural women?
It's
what exactly are the local governments doing?
I'm sorry to say, even if the local governments were the one responsible for distributing this stove, what I am saying is there's no need. We don't have a national need. It is not a national emergency that we are so desirous of stoves, for God's sake. That is not our problem. Our problem, as it were today, is enough supply of food, feeding items to Nigerians. That is what I know, because I am obviously in the know, like you are in the know, that more than 60 million Nigerians are out of employment. That is a major crisis. You know, we have issues with our education. We have issues with our health. We have issues with supply of food items.
You can watch Deji 360 in full on our website, www.tv360nigeria.com, or on our YouTube channel, youtube.com/TV360Nigeria. The program also airs on LTV this Saturday at 12 noon and on TVC on Wednesday at 3 p.m. with a repeat broadcast on Sunday at 8 p.m.